her revenge on you is instant.
It is the woman's job to keep the guy.
Because women can smell a bitch on a man. 3, 2, 1.
It's been far too long since we've done a freshman.
Yes, it's been a very long
time.
All
these women are out of control again. What else has been happening since I've done a freshman fit? You still can't park. They're letting you fly planes. That's a mistake.
Olte is back.
Yo, Olte is back.
Olte is fucking go, Andrew. Let's fucking go. Let's go. What the fuck's going on?
Olte went to jail.
One of the worst things we can do as men is to be with women who don't want us. I've been in that position too. I have simped. I've been in the friend zone. I've done all that kind of stuff. And I will tell you, gentlemen, don't do it. Never do that. It's never a good idea. Stop trying to win women over. And see, that's the beautiful thing about becoming a high value man. You don't have to win women over. You deal with the women who show interest in you and want to get on your program and are proving their worth to you.
And I don't want to say anything too controversial.
Oh my God. It feels to me like he's about to say the most controversial thing he said so far. That's what it feels like.
We're fucking back. The majority were back. They're going to jail.
Women take 9 months to grow a single baby. If men could grow babies, it'd be like 2 weeks. You need to sit down and say, listen, I love you with all my heart. You're just too slow.
But the truth is, as a man, if you have a good woman can be the best thing about your life and your greatest source of strength. And if you have a bad woman, she'll fuck your head up and fuck your life up and fuck your reputation up on every level. A woman can make or break a man's life. Same job, same house, same car, same dog, same sofa, same bed. Different bitch, different reality. And even worse, you'll notice this the most when you have a girl who flips, who was cool, and now she ain't. And you're like, everything was good. Now you're upset. What? Over what? That's why it's so important you make the correct decisions and you don't end up taking the wrong woman from the wrong background trying to put a triangle in the square circle.
Because women can smell a bitch on a man, like it or not. And when you live life scared, you live in life like a bitch. A beta bitch. You want to live life to the fullest? You got to kill the beta. The beta is fear. The beta is scarcity. The beta always asks a question. If there's a guarantee, you will go. That's beta. The top 20%, the thing you guys all say you are, those are the guys that lead from the front. Those are the guys that take the path less traveled. Those are the guys that make a road where no road existed.
Traditional values that they need. They sit down and say, you know what? I need a man who makes $100,000 a week, and I want a man with traditional values, and he's a masculine man who's going to take care of me, and he's going to marry me. Bro, you're a hoe, right? it blows my mind. Every time I watch your show, traditional values, they went out the door when you spread your legs 55 times. What are they talking about traditional values for?
Andrew, I'm not trying to get put back in jail. I know when you're around these guys, you like to say outrageous things that some people consider misogynistic. I am not trying to get put back in jail. It's Valentine's Day.
These sluts.
For the love of God.
These sluts.
Let's go.
These sluts, bruv. They all want to get married now. They're all trying to try the tradcon route. No, I want to get married. I want to get married. You don't want to get married because you want to be a man's wife. You want to get married because you want to show off on Instagram. You want to publicly cuck the man, put him in a position of servitude and slavery. Mm-hmm. You want him to get down on one knee and you want to get a photo of it and a big fat diamond. And you want to wear a dress and look pretty. And you put it all over your Instagram and say to all the other hoes, look. Look what I got my slave to do. My slave gave me all this shit. When some dude who had a bus pass, few years before a bus pass and no hopes, managed to get in between your legs and take the fucking gold.
For free.
For free. So don't talk about being a wife or traditional values unless you live traditionally.
I'm going to jail.
You're going to jail. If you're a virgin.
We're all going to jail.
If you're a virgin, you can come at me with that stuff. Otherwise, behave yourself. What else has been happening since?
You know when I gave my phone to the chick?
I'm doing everything.
And then I slept with that one there. Can't remember her name. And everyone's like, oh, I want to do it. I did it first. I'm the fucking originator.
A girl's like, oh yeah, I can fight guys off. And you're like, what do you do?
There was a crazy man at the door. And not a single woman stood up to fight. Why is that?
My bad.
Taekwondo.
Legendary.
Are you saying now that you don't have girls as friends? Is that what you're saying?
Oh, platonic female friends? Absolutely not, no.
You don't at
no.
all?
No. What ends up happening a lot of times when you have female friends is you end up being her emotional tampon. You end up being her solution provider. You end up being her masculine energy. You end up being a lot of boyfriend traits. to that girl inevitably because it's just a male instinct, right? They've done this too. Why did women not be allowed in the military infantry for so long? Because men have a natural provider and protector instinct. When a woman is, you know, getting attacked in combat or whatever, men are going to spring to action to try to help her and compromise the unit. So this is why women have been kept out of infantry and combat position for so long. So I say all that to say this. If you end up as a friend with a female, you're inevitably going to take on boyfriend traits whether you want to or not naturally. But her, on her end, she's not necessarily obligated to give you any type of sexual access. So what's happening is it's a one-sided relationship, which a lot of girls that are, you know, put guys in a friend zone, they're able to benefit and get the benefits without the guy getting what he wants.
She knows.
Right? And a lot of you guys, all of you guys right now probably have at least one or two guys that's in a friend zone that would hook up with you in an instant if you called them, but you would never hook up with them. But you're still able to siphon off benefit from them. Men, we don't get it that way. So I look at it like, okay, from a logically sound perspective, why am I going to be friends with a female when I know for a fact I'm not going to get any type of reciprocation? And then on top of that, it's someone that can't identify with my masculine problems. It's an L for me altogether.
Perfect.
And that's why. Another reason why men don't want their girlfriend or wives with the boy best friend.
Thank you.
If I had a wife and she said, I want to go party with Mike and Nathan, I'd be like, who's Mike and who's Nathan? No, you're wrong. And if she says, well, I'm going to do it, I'll say, fine, then I'm not your husband. Goodbye. I'm not going to attack her. I'm not going to beat her up, but I have standards. Masculinity in and of itself is built around enforcing parameters. And you enforce parameters with your children, in your business, in your relationship, in your friendships. That's what you do as a man, but you're not allowed to now. That's how they attack masculinity. No, you have to accept everything, especially from women. If you don't accept everything from women all of the time, you're a misogynist. If you have any standards whatsoever, you're a bad person.
Has he asked you to marry him?
No, this conversation was, he brought up marriage.
So, let me stop. How long you guys been together?
We were together for 2 years.
And he's never asked you to marry him in 2 years?
No.
Get out of there. What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
Okay.
First of all, all these kids, and you talking about stuff that ain't even on the table yet. If he's not said, hey, Alabama, I sure would love to marry you. And in 2 years, he does know where K Jewelry is. He knows what Gorge Jewelry is. He knows where to not. He knows where to go. Then he knows, and he's 40 years old. And he got two kids.
He's 43 now.
I don't give a shit. He's too damn old to be doing this. 6 months. He's no.
Got you.
Deal breaker. Got you. Boom. Bye. Delete. Block on social media. Block on Twitter. Get rid of. You think I'm laughing? I'm not laughing.
No, get rid of all.
Go nuclear. Get rid of all mutual friends. Move churches if you have to, but hell no. Get out of there. Okay. Get down to the chopper. Go, bye, no. All right, now get up off my phone. Okay.
What I've noticed is that women's experiences heavily influence their views of the world, which, I mean, all humans are biased to that, right?
Yeah.
But keep in mind, she was with an athlete pretty much her entire adult life. Now she's at a certain status where only those types of men are even attractive to her. But what women don't realize is that that's a very small minority of men. And that's why, when you said earlier, I'm the prize, we all laughed at you. Because the reality is that a guy that is at the NFL is less than that 1%. So it's he's really the prize. You don't even come close, no offense.
When you get laughed at for having standards.
How tall do you want your guy and how much does he got to make per year?
Height doesn't matter that much.
Could be 5'5"?
No, he has to be taller than me.
How tall are you?
How tall are you?
5'8".
Okay, so could he be 5'9"?
Yeah, that's fine. 5'10".
Okay, so 5'10". So height doesn't matter.
The taller the better, but it really doesn't matter as long as he's fitting the other requirements.
How much money per year?
Right now, 500K-ish, but then he should still be building. That's just the minimum.
That's the minimum, okay?
Yeah.
And what race does he got to be for you?
It doesn't really matter.
All right, what does he get in return for making 500K and being 5'10" plus?
He gets me and my energy and my vibe, and I'm a really amazing person.
Describe to us how you're amazing.
Hold on, you have good energy?
Yeah.
How much it costs?
I mean, it's not about cost. He has to have the same vibe as me, basically.
So your energy's worth 500K?
Energy's been
That's just an idea, you know what I mean?
Idea.
That just gives you the idea.
Him having 500K is an idea, that's real.
That's real.
No, money's energy too.
Yeah, so. Just that, the number just shows what kind of relationship you're going to have with them. I don't want to be hey, let's go here. Oh my God, I have to, oh my God, please. If we're traveling, right, we're traveling.
Hold on. But what does he get in return for bringing that amount of money to the relationship? What does he get back in return?
He's getting me going with him to the trips.
So you're saying... For 500K, he gets a tag along with good energy, that basically is just going to tag along.
Not just tag along, but it's like me. He has to like me, and if he likes me, and he can decide if...
We're asking you.
Her revenge on you is instant. Her revenge on you is going out to party, and you're sitting at home alone. Her revenge is instant. Your revenge takes a little bit longer, but it is a better revenge overall. Like all good things in life, good things come to those who wait. Good things don't come instantly. Your revenge is going to be using that sadness, using that sorrow to become such an amazing man that she realizes she f***ed up. And so if you get to take that sadness and sorrow and truly become the man that you know you can become, your victory comes. It's maybe a little bit delayed, but it's certainly not least coming, and you should be excited by that. There'll be a day where she regrets the decision she made. There'll be a day where she understands that she f***ed up and her life would have been better if she kept me. And I'm going to prove it to her. That's what you have to do. You have to go do it. You have to go and force her to feel regret by the magnitude of your actions. If you sit around your ass being mopey, she ain't going to feel regret. If you text her, you're going to regret losing me, she ain't going to feel regret. You have to get up and attack the universe. And through the force of your monumental achievements, the universe is going to create a massive sadness ball, a nice big ball of regret, and dump it on her fucking head. You can do that.
Once you hit 30,
mm-hmm.
No offense.
No.
Why would a man go for a 30-year-old right. when he can have a fresh 21-year-old that okay. men look at it as, oh, she's 30, which means she's older, mm-hmm. she's been ran through, she's tarnished, she's hardened by all the relationships, so she's lost her femininity because she's masculine.
That's what I want to ask her.
Wow. Men think about these type of things, mm-hmm. and it's very unfortunate that women don't realize that until they hit 30. They want to be in their 20s and be like, oh, yeah, I can fuck this guy, fuck that guy, but they don't realize you're ruining yourself. Trying to find yourself, and by the time you're 30, you're like, where have all the good men gone? Not to you, because you ran through.
Yo.
Damn. When was the last time a woman was legitimately excited to see you? I mean, legitimately excited to see you. Like a puppy or a dog when you come home from a hard day's work and they're just sitting there at the door. When's the last time that ever happened? Has it ever happened? If not, I gotta ask you, if you're not married, if you're out here dating, why are you settling for just mediocre? Why are you settling for transactional? In my opinion, you take a good long look in the mirror, get honest with yourself, and then decide to do the work. You know what I say? Take a year off, get your body right, mind tight, image together, purpose on point, game on lock, and get back out there. Set a standard that is going to make you happy. Go after your happiness, because when you're happy, she's happy. Because when you're happy, you can make her happy. When you're unhappy, you can't do anything for any of the women you're dating.
You guys might make a million on only. You're trading a million for 45 to 70 years of loneliness. A million is a house.
But they said they're okay.
It's not worth it, dude. There's a lot of life to live. She gave up a 3-year marriage to go to Miami.
Oh yeah,
a 3-year marriage from Miami. She said, "Well, he didn't let me go to Miami."
You say men?
She threw away a 3-year marriage.
Sir, you're making her cry.
Oh shit.
I'm sorry. We just been through a lot, and I don't know what else to do.
All right, well, I guess...
I'm going to burn it. I'm going to burn it.
The truth hurts. Women can't handle the truth. They really can't, bro.
It's very easy to just run around and fuck girls and not love any of them. That doesn't make you a hero. You're a hero if you love someone who you know can break your heart, who might leave. That's bravery. It's hard to do the right thing. All the time. It's hard to be with somebody and sit down and both of you admit you both did wrong and you want to make it work. That's hard. Most people take the opposite. What's the opposite? Ego? No, I'm perfect and I don't do anything wrong and you do everything wrong. But then what does it lead to in the end? I believe in the end it will lead to misery. I think that's where a lot of people end up. They leave the relationship they have. They think the grass is greener. They get over there and realize it isn't. Try and come back. Left, right, boom, misery.
It is the woman's job to keep the guy. There's a reason why you guys chase marriage and a man's last name. It's not our job to keep you. It's your job to keep us. That's the truth. And if you guys don't understand that cold, hard reality, I promise you, you're not going to have a happy relationship. You need to be with a guy that you want to chase and be with and that you're happy to be around. And you have to do that by, you got to want him more than he wants.
I guess I was engaged for like 3.5 years before I got out here.
So you guys just broke up because you wanted to move with your sister?
Yeah. He was really good and all, but I wanted to move out to Miami to be able to have more connections with people.
She gave up a 3-year marriage to go to Miami. A 3-year marriage from Miami. She said, well, he didn't let me go to Miami.
You say men?
She threw away a 3-year marriage.
What are we even admiring? Like,
yeah, well, yeah, it is what it is.
Where are these women's father? Why am I doing the job?
What the fuck?
I'm not the dad, bro. I'm not supposed to give the truth bomb.
What about you? What would you advise your son about women?
Women are very good at manipulating, and 9 times out of 10, you're not the only one.
Damn.
You aren't the only one.
Is that from experience?
For sure.
Okay.
We got some real ones in the house today.
I'm intent on. You want a loyal alpha. Why? Where in history have women ever been able to make that kind of demand of such a rare man?
I don't think ever. I mean, I understand it. I feel like every man that I've dated of high value has always wanted more women, but I just never. So is that something we should just deal with?
Where in the history of human beings have men of high high standing ever been expected to be solely monogamous?
I guess I don't know.
Saying what's universally attractive to a majority of women. You can say, I want support, I want these other things, whatever. Women are never going to tell you what arouses them. They're going to tell you what they want, but what they want doesn't necessarily get their pussy wet. The things that arouse women are not politically correct. Yeah. So it is not in a woman's best interest to tell the truth about what arouses them. Women say, I don't want you to cheat on me. I don't want you to have multiple bitches. But guess what? If you have multiple bitches, she's going to like you more. She's going to respect you more. And best, yes, she's going to give you the best sex. But women will never admit that. They won't. Women are not equipped to tell you the truth about what they really like, what they're attracted to. Hell,
if a woman gets ghosted, it's not the man's fault, it's the woman's fault.
She didn't add value.
Yep.
I learned.
She was useless, or she didn't bring peace, or whatever it may be. But a lot of women tend to blame men for getting ghosted. The reality is, guy game is game attaining the girl. Girl game is retaining the guy after you fuck him. And unfortunately, many modern day women can't do that because they think, let me just show up, you know, throw him some box here or there, be pretty, etc., and that's enough. And yeah, that'll be enough to maybe get flown out, go on a trip here or there, whatever it is, and get some sexual attention from high value men. But that does not mean that you're going to get relationship type attention. And that's where I think the disconnect is.
Stop trying to find your manhood through your dick. I want you black men to imagine a world where I did this. Snap my fingers. Thanos, reality stone, and away goes your penis and your balls. Every last one of your black dicks goes away. Then what are you? Your testosterone levels stay, your muscular levels stay, everything else remains, but your dicks are all gone. Where are you? What kind of man are you? Far too many of us black men try to make our masculinity and manhood through our dicks. We spend an inordinate amount of time in our youth trying to fuck our way into manhood. That's why you got so many young guys who aren't even where they should be, thinking, I can fuck my way in, I can make her this. And where do you rank amongst other men? We're the only group of men who walk around with our dick thinking that makes us a man. Go around other groups of men. They don't have to walk around and hi, I'm the CEO. Hello, or whatever the accent you want to put in. They are not judged.
10 men, 10 women drowned in the Mono Desert Island, and they had to survive. Very quickly, the men would do men shit, and the women would do women shit.
I don't even understand. We cannot walk anywhere on this island without getting lost.
And they dry clothes and no fire. It's going to take hours.
I'm just hoping that we can get some food.
Sheep fly!
I mean, you got 100 plus men telling you here that they prefer women to have lower body counts.
Yeah, all of them are delusional.
What?
Yeah.
This is the quintessential example of what I mean when I say female standards are respected and supposed to be adhered to, whereas male standards are considered delusional. Let me ask you a question. Would you say that in general, most women prefer a man taller than themselves?
Yeah, that's true.
Would it be fair to say that in general, women prefer a man that makes more money than them?
I guess some. Yeah.
In general, would it be fair to say that women want a guy that is more confident and ambitious than themselves?
Yeah, those things, yes.
Okay. What if I said that women are delusional for these inherent standards?
I don't think it's delusional to have those standards.
Stop the show right there. I don't think it's delusional that they want women that have low body counts.
Yeah. Right.
Hold on, stop the show.
The reason.
But here's the problem. Many of you blow relationships with quality men because you don't know how to be in a committed, faithful relationship. You don't know how to turn the TV off. You don't know how to shut down all other outside attention from men and just focus on one man. So you're always keeping all your doors open, all your options open, so you never really have time to bond with this man. And he's into you, talking to you, dealing with you. Men are not that complicated. When we choose somebody, we choose because we're trying to get on down the road and build and do life. But you still got 51 million things.
Men and women are not the same. Women like attention. Men want sex. So my thing is, a man is capable of having sex with other women while still loving his girl the same.
You're actually saying that in a relationship, it's okay for men to go and explore other options, but we have to be happy with you and not explore options.
Absolutely. Closed on your end, open on my end, and I think it should be honest between the two.
Why? That's Why would crazy. Anyone agree to that?
You can't just get throwing that thing around. I spoke to Dan Balserian. Yeah, I'm sick of you asking to finish your long, boring answers that are the same answer every time we ask you a question. Even Dan Balserian last week told me to my face, so fucking what, clown? Here you are on the show. I can turn you off as well. Just turn these clowns off. See you, fellas. Grow up. Ring us back when you're 30 and you've got half a brain. You're not running around being led by your own dicks. Bye-bye. See you later. Turn them off.
What is the most romantic thing a man can do for a woman, and what's the most romantic thing a woman can do for a man?
Okay, so I'd say the most romantic thing, I'll just use my own marriage, for instance. Obviously, for a woman being able to cook and clean, but I'll give some more specific examples like what I do. I wake my husband up with a massage and coffee every single morning, and every single night I'm scratching his scalp and like giving him a back massage until he falls asleep. It's important that he falls asleep first. And I would say something that's romantic that he does for me, well, since I do all of the cooking, it's nice when he takes me out for dinner because it's like a little break and it's just special. And then also, even just while we're here in Miami, he's kind of like my little bodyguard, like making sure if there's any men walking by, he just like puts his arm around me and just making sure that I'm protected. That's what it's really romantic, and that's something that a woman could never do for a man.
Wow.
Fantastic. Wow. I like it.
You are blessed.
I think a lot of women should really take heed to what you're saying.
Fact.
It's really, really, really great.
Very good points. Both you guys.
Yeah.
18. Good mindset. You watch our podcast, so you already kind of understand what men want. Just grow your hair out longer. Get rid of the nose ring. Go to the gym. Take care of yourself. And don't be corrupted by feminism. 19 years old. Attractive. I can see already that like some toxic feminism traits have kind of seeped into you, where you think men and women are somewhat equal, etc. But I can see some Eastern European influence still there. Are your parents together?
No.
They're not? Okay. Where's your father at?
I don't really. I mean, he lives here. I don't know exactly where. Sometimes in contact.
Okay. Get in more contact with him. Your father's going to keep you from being a whore. Your mother's not going to help you with that, unfortunately, because fathers teach women how to stay off shore poles and give them boundaries and teach them how the world really works. Mothers, unfortunately, are there to nurture you and make terrible disciplinarians. So build that relationship back with your father. Trust me, he will protect you from yourself. You need that masculine authority in your life.
So what would you do if I was going on holiday every other month?
Like, you'd be single.
Really?
Are we going together? Are you going by yourself? Sometimes. Oh no, you'd be single.
What would you do if I couldn't cook?
You'd be single.
Can you cook?
That's irrelevant.
No, can you cook though?
I mean, can you fight? Let's ask pointless questions.
How is it a pointless question? Because, I'm trying to get to know you.
Because that's your job.
What's my job?
To make sandwiches.
Did he actually just say, my job is to make sandwiches?
How am I gonna fight off the intruders if you don't make sandwiches? I need sustenance.
You're a dick. Why are you wearing glasses?
I have bad eyes because after so many fights in the ring, I had a retina detachment and there's a lot of bright lights here, and it makes my eyes very uncomfortable. So if you want to continue to make fun of my medical condition,
why would I make fun of it?
You just tried. I know you just tried. No, it's fine.
No, it was a genuine question.
Yeah. I just tried to make mock me. It's fine. Versus men's mental health, but if you got a retina detachment, it's fine. No.
Actually,
it's funny now.
Actually, I was asking you because eye contact is important to gauge conversation.
Is it? Do you want to look in my eyes?
Like how we're enjoying. Yeah.
Let me see. Give it a few minutes.
It's etiquette, isn't it?
It is. You're right. It's polite.
Perfect. A great option for me.
Yeah.
But what if I wanted to be your wife?
My wife?
Yeah, what if I want to be your wife?
100 men. Mm. You want to be my wife for 100 men? Let me ask you this. Do you think if you had 100 men, you could really bond with me all the way?
Yeah.
Still?
Yep. May the best man win.
You don't think...
Strongest bond.
You don't think that after the 100 men, you might have some animosity towards me, like in terms of like, all men are this way, all men are that way.
I don't know if I can trust you. I say all the time, there's only like 3 to 4 relationships somebody has before they actually say, you know what, I'm tired of this. I think all people are the same. That's what I think. So you have 3 or 4 in you, good relationships, and then it's like, you know what, this isn't working out. I think most people are...
Would you be with me if I had slept with over 50 men? I'm a high-value woman, right? You said it yourself.
How can you be high-value?
50 men or something. I've just been single for a long time.
No, unacceptable.
Why is it unacceptable?